Do you know what the best thing is about running this YouTube channel? It's that every time I upload a video trying to teach you something, I myself learn something in the comments. And then of course I make a video about it, taking all the credit. No, of course not. Look, on my last color grading video, Diggies82 commented this, basically saying that there's a better way of color correcting your videos by setting the gamma of the node to linear and then correcting the colors using only the gain wheel. Now, I was immediately intrigued, but I didn't know why, what, how, so I did some research and, well, yeah, this is how I color correct my videos now. But let's start from the beginning for all the beginners watching. So color correcting is not the same as color grading. Color correcting is what you do before you start color grading, basically. It's the part of the color grading process where you correct mostly the white balance or temperature and the tint of an image. So you want to get the colors right before you start color grading. Is it too warm or too cold? Is there too much green maybe or too much magenta? And there are different ways to do that, right? You can use the temperature and tint slider. You can also use the raw tab if you're using raw footage. You can also use the curves. That's a bit more difficult, but it's possible. But I always use the primary wheels. Lift, gamma, and gain in combination with offset. But the problem with using those is that any of those wheels not only affect colors, but also the brightness. And they also add color where you don't want color to be added. Look here, for example, how the offset wheel adds some blue contamination, if you will, in the shadows that you don't get when using the gain wheel in a linear node. And when you're color correcting, ideally you want only to change the colors of your video and not the brightness. And this new method does exactly that. How does it work? It's super simple, like really super simple. All you have to do is set the gamma of the node in which you're going to color correct to linear. So just right click on the node, set the gamma to linear. And then set the luminance mix here to 0. And that's it. And now you can use the gain wheel to color correct your image. And it's the only wheel you have to touch. And look how fast and easy it is. And how good it looks, it's amazing. Look, here in the vector scope, see how everything shifts by adjusting the gain wheel? And you're not messing around with brightness or anything, just colors. And a super fast way of getting it right without guessing is by using the vector scope. Just make sure that here, display qualifier focus is enabled. And when that's enabled, when you go over your image with the mouse, it shows you where those colors are on the vector scope. See, these are the blues, these are the yellows. And so a super fast way of color correcting your image is, well, not always, but a lot of times it is, it's by making sure that the whites are neutral, so that the whites are 100% white, no color cast. And so all you have to do is put the mouse over something white, my hat for example here, and then look at the circle here in the vector scope. When the whites are 100% white, that circle will be exactly in the middle, because the whites should be exactly in the middle when they're 100% white. And so now you can see that the circle is a bit too far up and to the left, right? Too much yellow and red. So all you have to do is pull the gain towards the opposite, like this. When I check it now, the circle is exactly in the middle. So the whites are exactly in the middle, 100% white. Here's another example. That wall there is white. I know that because it's our living room. And in the vector scope, you can see that there's way too much yellow and green. Now, that day when I filmed this, the sun was out, so it's normal that it looks a bit warmer and yellower, but this is a bit too much, right? So let's correct it. Set the color correcting node gamma to linear, Lumamix to 0, and then pull the gain away from yellow and green. And now, because, like I said, the sun was out, I can leave it a little bit warmer. It doesn't have to be 100% neutral white. And boom, perfectly color corrected image in less than 30 seconds. And that's it, just try it out. It will drastically improve your color grading and it will save you so much time. Thank you so much for watching and see you in the next one.